All right, so let's talk about this. So let's see. What basically happened is what I thought was going to happen, to be honest. I knew that he was going to end up being this overpowered character, and of course, that's what happened. He's an OP character as the main character. And for a while there, it was touch and go, but of course, at the very end, he gets his powers, which very predictable. Sorry, don't typically like it when the show is that predictable. It would have been better if they would have gradually over time, like through a couple of episodes, and built up the suspense a little more. Maybe that would have helped a tiny bit with the actual like point of the story, but of course they weren't gonna do that. But I was very impressed with them choosing to have his best friend, but become no longer his best friend as they were children, which is very strange because they haven't actually explained why, which means it's going to take time probably to explain what actually happened. Yes, there was a flashback scene where it looks like he's beating up some old dude trying to save his friend from getting, the pendant stolen, whatever the pendant means. I'm curious about that. So I do think I will continue this anime. I give it about 4 stars so far for the first episode. I really do wish that they would have taken a little bit longer on introducing him as actually having magical abilities. But beggars can't be choosers. It's a pretty interesting story overall. So yeah, I give it a 4-star rating. So I do think that you guys should try and check it out. Like I said, though, this is just based off the first episode, and I will continue watching it. But I don't think there will probably be much of a revisal of my rating, because usually the first episode or two kind of sets the tone for the entire anime. And usually animes don't steer too far off. This does seem to be an ongoing anime, or at least it's a very long anime. I think it's about 63 or 68, one of those two numbers, episodes in, maybe even more than that, since this is just the English dub that I am watching. I do like the voice acting characters. I like how they like interpret the words that they are speaking and how to interpret the tones and such. I do like that. There isn't too much else that I have to say about this anime. I am a comedy person, plus I love action. I love comedy and action. This anime puts both of those together. And it doesn't seem to have a romance plot line, a real romance plot line, which is good because I really don't want to see a romance plot line that gets too hardcore into romance. That kind of ruins the comedy aspect. And I like how the main character is the actual comic relief. I like when the main character is the comic relief instead of having it be a random side character that you only see sometimes. So, and I like how his friend, who is now his rival, is now kind of like, which he's not really friends with him at the time of this episode, it seems. But I like how he's studious and calm and because it definitely is a polar opposite to our main character, but eventually I'm sure he's going to open up at least a little bit, probably not be as full blown as his friend, but he should be pretty darn close, I think. So thank you so much for the recommendation of a Black Clover. I think I will continue watching this anime once again. I give it 4 stars out of 5, and I hope you guys have enjoyed the very first episode of Watching Anime with Trina.